that we're no longer at the manor. I have not done a video in a day or so because we've been at this place called Tropical Islands, and I've been here with the bride and my uncle and an American fighter pilot who's in the tent right now. So, and he would be too tall for me to get on camera. But we've been having a great time. Did you have a good time?
Yes.
Anything else you want to
say? No.
And did you have a good time?
Yeah, it was all right.
Did you have a happy ending or a sad ending? I had a happy ending.
Depressing ending.
Even for the bride. Not everybody got a happy ending. But it was a good time, so now we're going to be heading back to the airport hotel, and I fly out tomorrow. So this is, don't worry, I'm going to tell you everything that happened. Just not like right now. Oh, you want to come say hi? I'm doing a vlog.
Your dog.
Okay, wait, I have to hold it really high. This is, there we go, I got it, I got you. You want to introduce yourself and who you played?
I'm Jake, I played Jake, an American fighter pilot.
Am I Jake? Okay, yeah, more or less.
It's like me, but 1917.
Yeah,
it's, really easy.
It's me, but 1917, so, yeah, but we're going to go, so, bye guys.
Hey guys, so, I'm in the Berlin Hotel, I'm finally on my own. I guess, like, our trip's coming to an end. It's kind of surreal. I've been waiting for this for months, and almost in half a year, I've been living up to these few days. And it's kind of crazy that the dream is over, I guess. And Helena's gone, and I won't play her again. And it's crazy, but I may have been the first person to play Helena, but I can't wait to see how other people bring her to life, if they get the chance, you know. I had an amazing time. I met amazing people. I wouldn't have traded this for anything else, really. I don't know why I was so afraid, because everything was great. Everything was beyond perfect. It was beyond anything I could have thought. And I'm happy to be surrounded by such creative people. Oh, I told myself I was gonna cry. Such really talented role players and just really awesome, amazing, amazing people. You know, my experience was just... I could scream to the heavens about how awesome it was. And I think that the moral of this whole story and the theme of this whole trip is actually what somebody else told me. Because he watches what I do. I don't know, he probably is watching right now. But he said something simple to me. And in that moment, it became really obvious once the game had ended. He looked at me, he said, "Never be afraid." See? I would have felt like the biggest idiot in the world if I didn't do this just because I was scared. There was no reason to be scared. Everybody was amazing. Never be afraid. If you want to do something, just do it. If you want to go to a LARP that's half across the world, do it. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid about how you'll fit in, how you'll play your character. Just do it. Put love into everything that you do, and you'll do a great job. Sad, because I miss everybody so much already. Because I know I won't see anybody again until probably April, if I go back to College of Wizardry. I have another LARP coming up in January, which is Armistice Arcane. But that's in New Orleans, so it's not the same when you don't get to see some of your friends for a really long time. And I made so many new friends, it sucks because I won't be able to hang out with them for like almost a year. So I'm definitely gonna sign up for Fairweather 5 for sure. I hope you do too if you decide to go. You know, the service tickets will be up soon, and those are free. I think that if I go, I'm gonna try to either be Fairweather or maybe try for the bride, if I'm bold enough. But
I definitely want to do it again. I definitely want to play Nova again. I didn't think I'd be so emotional. But it was awesome. And for everybody that went and is watching this, thank you for an amazing experience. Thank you for making me feel so welcome. To the organizers, thank you for everything that you did, for making me feel so comfortable, so safe and welcome. And thank you to my Irish family, to everybody that was part of that whole, that was amazing. I loved every second of it. Jacob, Kat, Yepe, Simon, Elena, Richard, everybody, Laura. You guys were all really amazing. And I wouldn't have traded it for anything. And I'm really happy that we all were a close family. And that the family itself had a happy ending, even though, you know, not everybody will survive the war. But this was an incredible experience, guys. I can't wait to go into the stories in detail. I saved everything. I saved the newspaper articles. I saved the letters that were written to me. Like, I have everything. So, I have every picture that was drawn for me by Jean-Pierre. You know? And I wish I didn't have to go home yet. I wish I could have spent another day in Poland to hang out with people. But I guess that's life. So, I have a few hours, so I have to go. So I didn't want to check out yet. I think I'm just gonna hang back. Maybe finally do my makeup since game. I haven't done my makeup in like a few days. I've just been too lazy. Yeah, so I guess I'll talk to you when I'm home. Thank you to everybody. And bye.
I'm home. I'm jet lagged. But it was an adventure, guys. I did it. So I think what's gonna happen next is that I'm gonna post this vlog about how I came home. And then I'm going to, well, tell you what happened. I think I just need like a day though, because like, God. It's been a heck of a long time traveling home, so. Isn't it kind of weird to think that it's over now? No more updates. Hopefully I can get the story of what happened and all the drama, top to bottom, done by next week. So, yeah, guys. Thanks for coming on this journey with me. And, well, I'm going to the next one. I already smashed that checkout button.
I'll be playing a noble again next year too. And if you guys get to join me, I'll be more than happy to see you. So, I guess, talk soon.